Thank you, sir. Very pleasant good evening to all of present here. And today I am going to present about the study of accuracy of transverse cerebellar diameter in estimating fetal gestational age against conventional parameters in ultrasonography. And this was a study which was conducted in my hospital. And first, what is the clinical importance of the gestational age? So a pregnant woman comes to her OPD with suppose irregular cycles, or who has conceived in lactational amenorrhea, or with a PCOS. And in such cases, when we don't know her last menstrual period, then we have to rely on clinical findings. So in clinical findings, some variability is there. Whereas then we'll rely on our ultrasonography. So ultrasonography parameters, if in the first trimester it is chromatin, whereas in second and third trimester the other conventional parameters like BPD, AC and HC and FL. And whereas all these four parameters, they have their gestational age specific variations. So when by comparing all these, transverse cerebellar diameter, it has less variability when compared with the other parameters. So I would like to explain how and I would like to explain the results about my thesis. And what is the importance of gestational ages? In the first trimester, supposed to for scheduling investigations like chorionic villus sampling and amniocentesis, and for interpretation of this biochemical test, first trimester screening, quadruple screening, for these and all, gestational age plays a crucial role. And for assessing fetal growth, so for in the macrosomia, whether baby is going in for macrosomia or baby is going in for IUGL. So for example, a pregnant woman comes and her clinical examination fundal height corresponds to 35 weeks, but it is a macrosomic baby, then the gestational age varies. It's actually a 13 weeks baby with a macrosomia. Then again, these parameters, ultrasonographic parameters and all, it will mislead us. Whereas in the case of IUGR, clinical examination, we will get, for example, 30 weeks according to her gestational age. But clinical examination, it says around 20 weeks or 28 weeks. So then it is a classical IUGR where it will be again a misleading. And in the case of high-risk pregnancies, so we have to know the exact gestational age, whether to terminate the pregnancy, that is to prolong the pregnancy, or to what is the timing for delivery. So that's how the gestational age estimation plays an important role. And thus we can prevent the iatrogenic prematurity, and thus preventing the neonatal morbidity and mortality. And what are the various methods to estimate gestational age? So one is based on the clinical, first is as usual history. So history of the regular cycles and her first year of the last menstrual period. And then obviously it's the needle stool is well known to everyone, where the estimated date of delivery is calculated by the subtracting 3 months from the first year of last menstrual period and adding 7 days and 1 year. And the other one is historical is basal body temperature. The other one is from the date of thickening and the fetal tones by Doppler method. And then clinical examination from the fundal height, symphysial fundal height measurements. And these are all plays a role in estimating, calculating the gestational age. The other one is what we are using regularly now is ultrasonography. And these are the various variabilities for each parameter. Suppose if patient has become pregnant by in vitro fertilization, that's a conceptional age, so plus 14 days, then the variability is around plus or minus 1 day, which is the most accurate because you know the time of embryo transfer. So from that you can estimate the gestational age. So that's the most accurate. And if you know the time of ovulation induction, artificial insemination, then the variability is plus or minus 3 days. In the case of basal body temperature, the variability is plus or minus 4 days. Whereas the first fetal heart tones by ultrasonography by a doctor is made of, then it is plus or minus 2 weeks. And from the date of quickening, it is semester physical examination, the variable t is plus or minus 2 weeks. And coming to the ultrasonography, it is given as plus or minus 8% of the estimate. I'll explain you how. And the first trimester, what we routinely use is crown graft length. Based on this, the variability in estimating gestational age is plus or minus 3 to 5 days. In the second trimester, we'll use all the below ultrasonographic parameters like DPD, abdominal circumference, head circumference, and femur length. And these are the gestational age specific variability estimates for each parameters. That is from 12 to 18 weeks. If you see for BPD, it is around plus or minus 1.2 weeks. And for HC, plus or minus 1.3 weeks. And AC, plus or minus 1.9 weeks. So like that, as the gestational age increases, the variability, if you notice, the variability also increases from 1.2 weeks in the BPD to 3.2 weeks in 36 to 42 weeks of gestational age. So, what are the limitations of these parameters is, with the increase as the pregnancy advances, the variability in assessing gestational age also increases. And in the case of uncertain dates, these parameters variability varies actually. So in the case of excessive molding and dolichocephaly, brachycephaly, all these abnormal head shapes, this measuring BPD and all this will be this will cause less reliable, this will estimate gestational age less accurately. In such cases, secondary biometric parameters are under study now, where transverse cerebellar diameter, binocular distance, and long bone lengths are being used. So among this topic of interest is transverse cerebellar diameter. And what is TCD? It's nothing but the cerebellum lies in the posterior fossa, and the what's the main importance is the cerebellum and the posterior fossa, these are aligned in such a way that they are perpendicular to the extrinsic compression. So that, thus the cerebellum, it withstands the deformation by extrinsic pressure better than the parietal bones. So hence in abnormal head shapes like dolichocephaly, brachycephaly and plagiocephaly, where biparietal diameter varies, this TCD, it will not vary. And in the case of excessive molding, biparietal diameter, head circumference, measurement and all, it will vary. But TCD will not vary. And in the case of multiple pregnancy also, the same holds good. And in the case of achondroplasia, femur length is shortened and this will vary. Whereas in TCD, this will not affect, TCD will not be affected in achondroplasia. And in the case of macrosomia, each and every parameters are increased. So BPD is increased, AC is increased, HC is increased, FL is increased disproportionately to the gestational age. So calculating gestational age with the help of those parameters, it will be a misguide. So in such cases, TCD plays a good role in estimating gestational age. The same holds good in the IUGR babies also. And according to a study conducted by Rees et al., they found that TCD from 15th to 24th week of gestation in millimeters is equivalent to the gestational age in weeks. That is, for example, if the TCD is 17 mm, then the gestational age of the fetus, concerning fetus, is around 17 weeks. If TCD is 18 mm, gestational age is 18 weeks. And this is the ultrasonographic view. It is measured in the transcerebellar plane. And we have to place the electronic calipers from the outer to outer margins of the cerebellum. And the landmarks are thalamus and cavum septum pellucidum in the third ventricle. Then we have to slightly rotate the transducer below the thalamic plane. And the posterior fossa, it shows a characteristic butterfly-like appearance of the cerebellum and is seen as two lobules on either side of the median in the posterior cranial fossa. And these are the, in the literature it has given as variable estimates for TCD is 12 to 18 weeks it is given as plus or minus 1 week. This is actually less when compared to the other parameters. Excuse me. And as the gestational age increases, this has shown as plus or minus 3.2 week, but which is less when compared to the other parameters. And this is a study which has been conducted and the main aim is to correlate the accuracy of TCD with the conventional parameters and to derive nomogram for our population. And it is a prospective observational study which was conducted during November 2017 to April 2019 at Public Health Center, West Mumbai, with a sample size of 191. And this is the inclusion criteria where single in pregnancies between 32 age with the age between 18 to 35 years, between 15 to 37 weeks of gestational age, with the regular cycles and non-LMP, and gestational age estimation done before 12 weeks by ultrasonography using CRL, and the low-risk pregnancies were included. And multiple pregnancies, congenital malformation, pregnant women with uncertain dates were excluded, and high-risk pregnancies were excluded. And the methodology, after obtaining the consent from institutional ethical committee, and the detailed history of the patient were noted, and in each patient, gestational age was confirmed with a history of non-menstrual last LMP, and all the patients were done dating scan and CRL was noted, and each patient was followed up till term, and scans were done from 18 to 24 weeks and 24 to 30 weeks and 30 to 36 weeks, and the following parameters were noted, and the results were. Among the study population, 52% belongs to the age group of 26 to 30 years, and 45% are primary gravida and 40% are second gravida, and the mean LMP gestational age in the study was 28.29 plus or minus 5.45 weeks, and in the study, TCD in MM was equivalent to gestational age in weeks from 17.50 weeks to 21 weeks. And these are the main various parameters like TCD, BPD and HCAC in the various gestational age which according to the study. And coming to the correlation with the last menstrual period, that is the clinical gestational correlation with the menstrual age. And the 18 to 24 weeks, this TCD, it shows good positive correlation with Spearman's rank correlation coefficient value of 0.686. Whereas you can see with the other parameters, it is around the values of 0.480, 0.488, where the TCD value is higher than with the other parameters. And 24 to 30 weeks also TCD, it shows moderate positive correlation. And 30 to 36 weeks, it shows strong positive correlation. And this is the comparison of mean variability estimates of TCD in weeks with mean variability estimates of the other parameters. That is, at the 18 to 24 weeks, the TCD variability is around 0.5 plus or minus 0.46 weeks. Whereas with the other parameters, you can see when comparing with the other parameters, the variability is less with the TCD. Even 18 to 24, 24 to 30, 30 to 36 weeks also, the variability is less and it is statistically significant. And overall mean variability is in the study, it came as around 0.55 weeks. For the TCD, whereas BPD 1.15 weeks, whereas HC and AC around 0.9 and FL is 0.87 weeks. And this is the nomogram which has been created based on the study conducted in our hospital for our population. Whereas, for example, like for TCD is 17 mm, gestational age corresponding is around 18.30, and if it is 18 mm, it is 18.92 weeks, and if it is suppose 20 mm, 20.15 weeks. And this is a nomogram for standardized residuals or TCD in the study population. And this is the comparison of variability estimates for the TCD which has in this current study with the other studies. So current study is around 0.5 in 19 to 24 weeks, whereas the study conducted by Hill et al, it is around plus or minus 1.8 weeks. And whereas 30 to 36 weeks, you can see it is 0.6 weeks only in the current study, whereas study conducted by Hill et al, it is plus or minus 2.4 weeks. So in this, overall the TCD is showing lesser variability when compared with the other parameters, and this indicates that the accuracy of TCD is better when compared with the other parameters in estimating fetal gestational age. And coming to the conclusion, so TCD in MM is almost equivalent to the gestational age in weeks up to 21 weeks, and TCD showed significant positive significant correlation with LMPGA, and it showed less variability which was statistically significant, and it shows positive correlation, better predictive accuracy but less variability, and nomogram has been created for our study population. And the recommendation, this study recommends the routine use of TCD in gestational age assessment along with other conventional parameters, as it is more accurate and more reliable, and it is less variable. So the further studies has to be conducted and need to evaluate in the larger sample size. With this, I would like to conclude. Thank you. These are the references.
Since she is doing a diploma and diploma, request the gynecologist members to ask questions.
I'm a neurologist, and you use the word TCD, transverse cerebral artery. The same word is used for transcranial Doppler also.